I just finished with the bookcase video. I've been spending the time organizing all my camera parts and wires and batteries and all that stuff. And I've created little piles on the bookshelves of things that I want to have grouped together in the storage containers. And I was going to let them sit, but I got some motivation behind me and I decided to just go out and buy some wood and start making them. We're going to go into a little bit more of a detailed process of how I build these boxes. It's very similar to how many other YouTubers build simple boxes like this. I'm just going to show you again with my setup and just have fun doing it. To speed up the process, I went ahead and bought dimensional lumber from the home store. These are 3/8 by 6 by 36 inches. And I think it's close to 3/8. I think it's really close to like 5.5. And all of these I want to be 11.5 by 11.5. So I'm going to set up my table saw with the cross sled and we're going to go ahead and cross cut all these to the right length. After cutting a rabbet on the side of each one of these, I went ahead and added a rabbet to the bottom of all the parts as well. I've already built one to test it out to make sure it goes together the way I want it to, and I measured the bottom and I've cut all of the bottoms as well. So I have all the parts for final assembly. Now I just need to put them together. And these go together a little bit different than most of the boxes I see made on YouTube. Because everything is the same, they kind of overlap. It's the same thing I did with the mailbox. Four pieces are all the same. So, rabbet goes onto one side of that, and then the next part has the rabbet go onto that, and then the final part has the rabbet go on here, and go onto that. That way they are perfectly squared. So, I'm gonna go ahead and build the rest of these. I built one. I have 8 more to go, and I think I'm gonna try another time lapse because I'm gonna get it right with this camera at some point. And today is a new day. You can tell because my t-shirt changed colors. The last thing you saw me do was do a little bit of router work on all the edges of the boxes and on the inside ring, on the inside perimeter. Basically, that's so when I have my arm in here, I'm not rubbing along a sharp edge. I do like the sharp edge on the top and the bottom. I will be breaking those a little bit with sandpaper, but I'm really happy with the way these turned out. A comment on the half-lap idea on all four corners. That's not my idea. I'm sure somebody has come up with it before. I just haven't necessarily seen it on any of the YouTube channels that I watch. I don't know where I thought of it. I think it just kind of came to me trying to make this easier to make. But I'm not claiming that to be my idea. If you've seen it from any other ones, awesome. I really like it. It makes things simple. It makes a nice square box that's easy to work with. And you can probably use the same method for making rectangular boxes. And I will be experimenting with that at a later date. But the last thing I need to do is to sand this with 120 grit sandpaper and then do a couple layers of clear coat, and then I can take them up to the studio and finish organizing that bookcase. But because of my rule with this camera, I'm going to end this video here. I will sand and clear coat these all off camera, and I'll show you some snapshots on my outro. As always, thank you for joining me. I hope you enjoyed coming along on this build, and I will see you all soon. Bye, guys.